Hello, everyone. Well, came the dawn this morning, and to borrow the title of one of the records to follow shortly, down came the rain. Inches deep all over the roads, grey and nasty and perfectly foul. So we won't dwell on that.
I'll be home, my darling.
Well, today there's a happy face on Alice Gately, I'm sure, because it's her wedding anniversary. Alice is at 7 Hartshead Road, Ashton-under-Lyne in Lancashire. Hello, Alice. As you can guess, this brings lots of love to you and many congratulations from your husband, Paddy, at Butzweilerhof, who says, and listen, thank you, darling, for a wonderful year. May the next 90 years be just as happy, if not happier.
Now, the card for this next one will take me almost as long to read as the record, so I'll go quickly through it. It's for the new brother-in-law of Linda Molyneux of Lockhouse, Marbury. His name is Private Raymond Ridgway, and he's alone. And I'm to tell you, Raymond, that they all miss you very much, and Linda says roll on Easter so she can have a big Easter egg for looking after your wife Iris for you. I'm also to mention Gran at Barbridge near Nantwich and all relations in London, Rochdale, Stockport, and, of course, your mum and dad, Ray, at 4 Orkington Gardens, Whitchurch, Shropshire. There's the message. Here's the record.
The time in Britain and Germany is 12 noon. In Australia, it's 9 p.m. In the Far East, it's 6:30 p.m. In Canada, it's 7 a.m. And in New Zealand, it's 11 p.m. Time once again for worldwide family favourites. Just for a change, let us not dwell on the weather situation here. Let's leap ahead 9 hours, which, according to my schedule, should bring us in line with Graham Webb in Sydney. Is that true?
That's true, Michael. How are you?
Fine, thank you. Are you sitting there in your Bermuda shorts?
Not tonight, no. I've got a jumper on, a polo neck jumper, because the weather outside isn't the very best. It's raining. I guess our temperatures are only about 60.
Well, with Michael Aspel bronzing himself on some sun-drenched beach somewhere, it's my pleasure to sit in London and do a bit of radio globe-trotting, starting with a call to Rod McNeil in Sydney. Hello, Rod. Nice to meet you.
Hello, Sandy. Great to say hello to you.
In Britain and in Germany, it's 12 noon, so at home and away, once again, it's time for two-way family favourites.
The voice, of course, of Jean Metcalfe, introducing today's 30th birthday edition of Family Favourites. And Jean, together with her husband, Cliff Michaelmore, has joined me in London here today for our little celebration. Welcome, very, very welcome, both of you. Delighted to see you. Must be a bit like coming home, Jean.
But it's lovely to meet you after all those years, because you used to be a mortar, didn't you?
Yes, many years ago.
We used to talk to each other.
And I think, can I introduce you to our two other compatriots, Michael Bagley in Belfast. How are you, Mike?
Hello, Sandy, and a very good afternoon, Jean.
Hello, Michael.
Makes me feel very sentimental, this. It was 52 or 53, I can't remember, I have a terrible memory for dates, that I did do a few of the programmes with you, actually, on the other end.
I remember that. Well.
Oh, marvellous.
And I don't think you need any introduction to Cliff, do you, Michael, since you worked together?
No, we didn't, actually, work together. I didn't arrive until 50, I think it wasn't. Cliff had just disappeared.
I was just going at the time.
Ah.
There wasn't room for both of us there, I worked out.
Thank you, Cliff.
However, Cliff, you have met, I know, Andrew Pastuna in Cologne.
Yes, he was. once came and interviewed me.
That's right. I was just saying I can always smell the roast beef and Yorkshire pudding. How about it?
Andrew, you've not yet met Jean.
Well, in fact, we did meet at our house in Redhill, I think, about 5 years ago when I was doing the 25th anniversary programme of BFN and seeing both children off to swimming. I can recollect that.
Good gracious, you've got a better memory than I have, Andrew. We hope both children are getting their lunch at this moment now. They're not children anymore.
No, they're not.
Now then, it's going to be a bit crowded, all five of us here together. Andrew and Michael, I'm sure you won't mind if we take the first record here. And Jean, how about you starting us off?
Love to. Yes, I've got a card here. And we're asked to play a record for Warrant Officer Harry Eggbeer, who's just returned to Germany for his third spell of duty, it says. The card, Harry, comes from your parents, Mr. and Mrs. Eggbeer, of Higher Roborough, I think it is, Ashburton in Devon, and it brings you also love from your sisters, Valerie, Lynn and Pam, and your brothers, John and Fred, and your sisters and brother-in-law, and your 12 nephews and nieces. What an expensive Christmas in that family. Lots of love anyway, Harry, from everyone at home.
And Cliff.
The first thing I notice is it costs you 7 pence to send a postcard these days. Change from the halfpenny or penny in our day. This is to Sergeant John Dumphy with the 2nd Battalion of the Light Infantry in Lemgo. This is from your wife, Pat, your daughter, Heather. They're both very sorry not to have been able to spend your birthday with you, but they look forward to seeing you in November, or December, Let's hope the question marks are rubbed out and you do meet very soon.
And here's one from the Prince family of Pasture Avenue, Morton, Wirral in Merseyside. They have two sons away in Germany. Phil is with the army in Minden, along with his wife Isabel. Tony and his wife Jean are at RAF Bruggen. They're both living in married quarters there. Tony's two children are Tracy, who's 9, and Tony, who's 7. And Phil's little girl, Angela, was 4 years old on the 3rd of October. Lots of love from all the family, who miss you very much and are looking forward to seeing you at the end of the year. And our first piece of music on this 30th birthday programme is one that we played on the very first Family Favourites on the 7th of October 1945. Glenn Miller, I Know Why.
Stereo VHS. This is Radio 2.
Hello and a Happy New Year from Family Favourites. This is Jean Challis in London with messages and your choice of music in abundance to take across the airwaves to your family and friends in Australia, Hong Kong and, for starters, three ways at once to Northern Ireland and West Germany. So let's get together first with Hunky Stevie Withers in Cologne.
Jean, and a Happy New Year to you.
And to you, my love. How are things?
Oh, very well indeed, thank you.
Good, good. Well, look, you stick fast, Steve, for a second, will you? And I will bring in David Olver in Belfast to join us.
Hello, 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 and a very Happy New Year to you, Jean.
Thank you.
A new decade, in fact.
Indeed, and the same back to you, and thank you for the beautiful flowers, David.
Ah, my pleasure. Glad you received them, Jean.
I certainly did, and they lasted for the whole of Christmas. It was Twelfth Night yesterday, and I only threw them out then.
Jolly good.
Right, after all of that, it's 3 minutes after 12 here, and it's your turn to go first, David. Well, now I have time to tell you what will be happening when Pete Murray takes over the pleasant job of being the London end of Family Favourites. Pete's first show goes out, 2 weeks today, on the 20th of January, and on that day he will be in touch with your folks in West Germany, in Hong Kong, and in Australia. And now it's time to say thanks for taking part today to David Olver in Belfast, Steve Withers in Cologne, John Burton in Hong Kong, and Bob Hudson in Sydney, Australia. Family Favourites is produced by Keith Stewart. He and I will be waiting for you again next Sunday, just after 12 noon. And as it'll be my last time on the show, I hope that you'll be there with me. Between now and then, I hope that maybe the sun will manage to shine on you. You never know, it just might. But for now, this is Jean Challis wishing you warm and well and saying cheers till next time. Bye-bye. Thank you.
Right now, the time just after 2 minutes past 11. This is the Pete Murray Sunday Show. It's our call to Ian Thompson in New Zealand. And a very good day to you, Ian.
And a very good day to you, Pete. And how's everything your side of the world?
Oh, pretty good. Yes, I've just finished a play with Mike Aspel, Eunice Stubbs and Dillis Watling called Say Who You Are. We've been doing that for the last 7 weeks, and it's been really most enjoyable to hear the laughter and all that.